You are looking at the number one contender to your IWGP World Junior Heavyweight Championship. We ask that you tweet out this live stream, hashtag wrestling, hashtag NJPW, hashtag Noah underscore GHC, Koji Kanemoto making his way to the ring. We are going to get into some of the history, some of the credentials of this number one contender momentarily, as always. It is your host, Arachnid Soul in the booth. Let's lay out. Let's wait for the champ. Here's Liger. Time. There is bad blood between two wrestlers, but when you talk about Jushin Thunder Liger and the man in the ring, Koji Kanemoto, no bad blood. In fact, these two former junior heavyweight tag team champions, these two former best friends. Liger successfully defended his championship last month on the live stream against Minoru Tanaka. Can Jushin Thunder Liger do it again? Liger always comes out on top, but you've got to wonder if all of these title defenses are playing a role in the health, in the well-being of Jushin Thunder Liger. Let's go to that opening bell. Liger comes in, scores with the double leg. Once again, Arachnid Soul in the booth. Legendary referee Tiger Hitori. And listen to these strikes to start out this championship match. Full arm dragon twist that time from Koji Kanemoto. Liger could not score with the capo kick or the backhand knife edge chop. Koji Kanemoto going to the ankle hold, the ankle lock. The move he invented, a move emulated by Ken Shamrock, obviously by Kurt Angle. You see Koji Kanemoto going after the lower body of Jushin Thunder Liger. If Jushin Thunder Liger cannot fly, he can always go back to his technical wrestling. His catch is catch can. Yes, he's a junior heavyweight high flyer. Yes, he was a high flyer in Mexican Lucha Libre, but keep in mind that Jushin Thunder Liger also trained in Canada under Stu Hart. And when you talk about technical wrestling, the name Stu Hart comes up in the bios of so many wrestlers. Everybody from Bret Hart, Owen Hart, Bruce, Keith. We can talk about Lance Storm, Chris Jericho, the late great Chris Benoit, and so many others. Once again, we ask that you tweet this stream out. Arachnid Soul calling the action and thanking you for the success of last month's live stream. Liger coming in with those Shotei palm strikes. He's got to be careful here early on not to punch himself out. Let's lay out for a second. Listen to some of this action. And you hear the two men exchanging leather. The boots, the chops. Liger that time does connect with that capo kick. Liger will go to the top rope, it looks. And let's see if he can score off the top. A glancing elbow blow. Did not get that clean, but did score with all of that Shotei. Lateral press that time. Only got a two count. Liger hooking the far leg for that bit of extra leverage. Junior heavyweights in the ring. Let's talk about the heights and the weights. Koji Kanemoto, the challenger in the shorts, coming in tonight at 1.80 meters. That's 5'11" as we see the camel clutch, weighing in at 80 kilograms. That's about 180 pounds. When we talk about Jushin Thunder Liger, the height disadvantage with the slight weight advantage. Liger coming in tonight at 5'7", 1.7 meters. When we talk about the weight of Liger, 95 kilograms. And wait a minute, Koji Kanemoto here with the moonsault. It was that moonsault that brought. And once again, Koji Kanemoto not being able to get a cover because of the rope break. It was that moonsault that brought Koji Kanemoto to the dance. As we see the abdominal stretch, the Cobra Twist. When we talk about the awesome finishing moves of Koji Kanemoto, hold on a second here, Liger. Scud missile dropkick. No one home. Once again, Koji Kanemoto will go to the lower body of Jushin Thunder Liger, the ankle hold. When we talk about the finishers, the trademarks, the signature moves of Koji Kanemoto, as we see that Fujiwara armbar, you've got to talk about that Koji clutch. As Liger switched into the modified Rings of Saturn, the Koji clutch, a move emulated, a move copied by so many wrestlers around the world. Koji Kanemoto, instrumental in training the Fallen Angel, Christopher Daniels. Liger off the top. Jackknife press. Shades of the late great Black Tiger, Eddie Guerrero that time. The jackknife press frog splash. We see the Juji Gatami, but Koji Kanemoto, instrumental in training, in mentoring the Fallen Angel, Christopher Daniels. Christopher Daniels later, out of respect, started using the Koji Kanemoto clutch in the United States, as did one CM Punk. When we continue to talk about some of the signatures of Koji Kanemoto, we've seen the ankle hold, but you also need to watch out for that high angle bridging tiger suplex. Koji Kanemoto likes to use the moonsault, likes to fly, so does Liger. Goes plancha, suicida from the top turnbuckle. You are watching Thursday Night Throwdown Wrestling. You are watching your IWGP Junior Heavyweight Championship encounter of the night. The two men, the two best friends brawling over the richest cruiserweight, the richest X division, the richest light heavyweight prize in this sport of pure wrestler, in this sport of professional wrestling. Koji Kanemoto back inside now. He knows he can only win that belt inside the ring. Liger follows. There was a fall forward scoop slam there. Here's a receipt, Koji, with a Juji Gatami of his own. And when we talk about judo, when we talk about Toby Khan Judon, the master of the flying judo style submission holds, we can talk about Shinya Aoki. We can talk about Kazushi Sakuraba. There's so many individuals we can talk about, but it wouldn't be a complete conversation if we didn't talk about the man who trained originally in judo, Koji Kanemoto, a man who actually, before professional wrestling, as we see the lateral press, a two count and some change. Koji Kanemoto, a man before professional wrestling, who competed in Japanese style shoot fighting slash MMA, actually does hold a victory over the man I mentioned about 30 seconds ago, Kazushi Sakuraba. Irish whip that time, hammerlock throw, Liger comes back, baseball slide. Koji Kanemoto grabbing Liger by the horns, picks the ankle, dragon screw leg whip, shades of Keiji Muda, the great Muda. And now Koji Kanemoto spins through, spinning toe hold into the figure four leg lock. All night, the game plan has been the same. He has been all over the lower body of Jushin Thunder Liger. It's going to be very interesting to see if Liger, a man who likes to come into the ring, who likes to fly, will be able to switch up his strategy here against one of his best friends and will be able to come back into this. Liger now with a figure four leg lock of his own. Liger saying, hell, if you're gonna work my legs, you're gonna take away my high flying style, I'm gonna work your legs, I'm gonna take away that judo style, that Muay Thai style, I'm gonna take away that vertical base, I'm gonna take away those legs so you can't throw the roundhouse kicks, so you don't have the power behind the chops. Once again, Cobra Twist, hip toss there that time from Koji Kanemoto. Koji Kanemoto, front face lock. Wait a minute, that's Liger's move. Koji Kanemoto with the sheer drop, brain buster. Looking to beat Liger with that. Follows up with the moonsault. 2.9, we almost crowned a new IWGP Junior Heavyweight Champion that time. There's the complete shot, shades of Chris Canyon, shoots the half, lateral press. And once again, another 2.9 count. These are some of the closest counts we've ever seen on Jushin Thunder Liger in a match where he's defending his championship. Liger fires up, picks his man up, runs. Sit out, Liger Bomb. Two? No! And 2.9 the other way. What great action you are witnessing here tonight on the opening encounter of our live stream. Liger shoots in with the leg grapevine. Liger, a former CMLL, that's Lucha Libre down in Mexico, middleweight champion. Also, the very first ever WCW World Light Heavyweight Champion, defeated Brian Pillman for that championship. And when we talk about men who held that championship, another man in the main event tonight, Shinjiro Otani, in that grudge match, in that return match from the Catchweight Championship Tournament, will take on Takeshi Morishima. Fans, I guarantee, as we see the cover, fans, I guarantee you do not want to miss that. I give it my arachnid soul stamp of approval. Both of these men are fired up. Both are ready to go here tonight in the main event, as we saw that spin heel kick, Shades of Own Art. Tonight, Takeshi Morishima and Shinjiro Otani will throw down. Do not miss it. Liger executing momentarily that release German suplex. Wait a minute, traps the leg back. He'll sweep that time. Liger now, double leg, steps through into the Boston Crab. Liger continuing to work the lower body. And when you look at these two on paper, you would anticipate a more high-flying match, a more daredevil style. Now Liger going to a modified ankle hold. We saw Koji Kanemoto earlier on take Liger's brainbuster. Liger now with a receipt, going to one of the trademark holds of Koji Kanemoto. Liger so many times signals that that's it, hooks his man. Will this be the brainbuster? No, it's that rare fisherman's buster. Liger, north-south cover, thought better of it. That rare finisher we usually don't see from Jushin Thunder Liger. Liger, and I believe Koji Kanemoto's out, frog splash. Referee Tiger Hattori in position two. Yes, Liger keeps the belt. And some technical difficulties down here in the booth. I believe we're still on. I'm not sure what that was. Liger was celebrating in the ring, has been escorted out. Liger did win that match, still your IWGP champion of the junior heavyweight ranks. Let's now go to a match between best friends. Mitsuharu Misawa, the number one contender to the IWGP World Heavyweight Championship, currently held by Kenta Kobashi. His best friend Yoshinari Ogawa saying, let's go out tonight. I want to give you a warm-up match. Not only did Misawa say okay, but Misawa said he would put the number one contendership on the line against his best friend. And how rare is it to see two wrestlers who are about to compete against each other to come out to one entrance? The respect between these two, the best friends from All Japan Pro Wrestling, the best friends from Pro Wrestling Noah. It's Rat Boy in the zebra trunks. You see my boy right there in the green and white, Mitsuharu Misawa. This will be for the number one contendership for the IWGP World Heavyweight Championship. Tweet this stream out once again on Twitter. Hashtag wrestling, hashtag NJPW, that's New Japan Pro Wrestling, and hashtag Noah_GHC, arachnid soul, about to call the action in this second bout here tonight on the live stream. Let's lay off. As we hear that bell, these two best friends going to go at it. And almost a little bit there, almost a little bit of respect, if you will, the two not rushing in. Arachnid Soul once again in the boot. Irish whip to the corner. Misawa gets the boot up, rabbit style, elbow to the back of the skull, shoots the half lateral press. did not even get a one count. Let's get right into it. Let's get into what this match is all about. For 4 months this year, Masal was scoring with an elbow there, mid drop kick. Haven't seen that. Goes back, does it again. For 4 months this year, the Catchweight Championship Tournament. Lateral press. We saw the best junior heavyweights and heavyweights from around the world. It was a 4 month tournament. The winner of that tournament to get a shot at any championship he desired. The winner of that tournament at our last pay-per-view turned out to be the man you see in green and white, turned out to be Mitsuharu Misawa. Lateral press after the scoop and a slam, and once again could not get the job done. Mitsuharu Misawa can get that championship shot any night he wants, so long as he gives the world champ Kenta Kobashi and New Japan and Pro Wrestling NOAH upper management 1 week advanced notice. We just saw one of the finishers of Yoshinari Ogawa of Rat Boy, that bridging belly-to-back suplex hold. Rat Boy off the top rope, scores with the double sledge. Shades of the late, great Macho Man Randy Savage. DET that time. But let's talk about the fact that it was Ogawa stepping up to the plate and saying, listen, I want you to be ready. I want you to be set to take on Kobashi, spinning toe hold into the butterfly lock. And it was Mitsuharu Misawa saying, let's go out there tonight. Let's tear the house down on the live stream. If you can beat me, you're going to become the number one contender. This is the most important match in the throwdown career of Rat Boy, Yoshinari Ogawa. Once again, the scoop and a slam. Huge weight difference here, but do not count out Yoshinari Ogawa. Is not just called Rat Boy to sell t-shirts. Is not just called Rat Boy to look cool on the packaging of action figures. He's called Rat Boy because while he's smaller, he's known for the quick pins, the cradles. Almost like a Spike Dudley in the United States. Spike Dudley used to hit that acid drop, that ace crusher tornado style out of the corner and get victories over men 2 and 3 times his size. Yoshinari Ogawa, very similar, but very technical. Does it with his technical prowess. Does it with his catch as catch can. The corkscrew, belly to back suplex that time. And now Misawa drops back into the Jujigatami, a move a lot of the time miscalled the cross arm breaker. So tonight, everything is on the line in this match. The most important match for both of these men. Mitsuharu Misawa trying to remain the number one contender. Yoshinari Ogawa trying to become the number one contender. Once again, we can confirm that Liger indeed did get a 3 count. In that last match, Liger retains the championship. We apologize for those technical difficulties. We will look into them. And when you talk about a night of big matches, when you talk about a night, snaps off Le Cabra d'Or Conilo, the Tilt-A-World backbreaker, lateral press that time. When you talk about a night where we're bringing up old school, where we're talking about that Catchweight Championship tournament, there was a match that took place in that Catchweight Championship tournament. It was between Shinjiro Otani and Takeshi Morishima. That night, we saw Takeshi Morishima win that match, but he barely eked out with the victory. Since then, Shinjiro Otani has been on a warpath and has wanted a rematch with Takeshi Morishima. He says he's got Takeshi Morishima's number. He says he can beat Takeshi Morishima. He guarantees, here tonight live in Tokyo, Japan, he, and he being Shinjiro Otani, will defeat Takeshi Morishima. Morishima has his eyes set on an eventual shot at that IWGP World Heavyweight Championship. He doesn't care if the champion's Misawa at the time, if the champion's Kobashi, hell, if the champion's Ogawa. But in order for Takeshi Morishima to prove to upper management that he's worthy of that World Heavyweight title match, he must defeat Shinjiro Otani tonight. I've said it before, I have always delivered. Fans, tonight, believe me when I tell you, you do not want to miss the main event we have on tap. It will be a match of the year contender. Don't watch it on demand. Watch it live or you will regret it. Back to live action here. We see Rad Boy fire up. Let's see where he can go from here. Rad Boy now backing Misawa into the ropes. Irish whip that time. Hammerlock throw. Back comes Misawa. Shoots in with the drop toe hold. Great wrestling, like we've said. Great catch is catch can. Double underhook. What the hell is this? Tiger driver. That's Misawa's move. Two. No. Yoshinari Ogawa going to the finishing move of Mitsuharu Misawa. Seems to be almost like a theme here tonight. Picks him up belly to back. And I got to be honest with you. I got to be real honest. Yoshinari Ogawa doing better in this match than a lot of people would expect it. Misawa in serious danger here. Misawa needs to come back. Misawa needs to refocus, needs to regroup as we see the kneeling jawbreaker. Once again, you are watching Thursday Night Throwdown Wrestling. Our second ever live stream. Great counter that time from Mitsuharu Misawa. Lateral press counter out of the attempted belly-to-back suplex. Out goes Ogawa. Misawa goes elbow. Suicida. That might be the opening. That might be the breather if Misawa can capitalize on that. And no, Yoshinari Ogawa right back up. Hooks his man. Belly to back outside the ring on that unforgiving cold concrete. Yoshinari Ogawa really proving himself, in my opinion, here tonight. These two brawling, front face lock over the cable. Mitsuharu Misawa floats through, shoots in, double leg takedown. Great amateur wrestling that time from the man in green and white, from the man in green and silver. Bridging Tiger Suplex from the former Tiger Mask. And let's see if Mitsuharu Misawa has what it takes. And I'm getting word in the headset we have to take a commercial break. But check this guy out. Check out Fight Night's Finest.
What's going on? This is Marty Styles, and what we got here is Fight Night's Finest. Let's get ready to rumble! Fight Night's Finest. Let's step in the ring where the lights are blinded. I'm about to just knock you out. Now your mouthpiece, you cannot find it. You cannot face the weather. Warming up like Mayweather's weather. Super fast like Mayweather. You cannot put your face together. Cause my hands is lightning speed. I don't really think people wanna fight with me. You'll likely flee like Frazier from Foreman. Guaranteed tonight you'll bleed. Looking like I swiped your feet from under you. I'm like Tyson Beast. I punish you. I don't think that there's nothing your freaks are gonna do but sleep.
We are back. Thursday Night Throwdown Wrestling. And if you want to check out that man you just saw in that commercial, Fight Night's Finest, there's one place to go. YouTube.com/Fight Night's Finest. YouTube.com/Fight Night's Finest for all your boxing needs. YouTube.com/Fight Night's Finest. Misawa, Ogawa, going at it. God, there's the rolling elbow. Mitsuharu Misawa will go up top, will go to the Falcon's Nest for the Hayabusa fans out there. It's the move Liger just won with, the jackknife press. The frog splash, only getting a two count. Look at the fighting spirit of both of these men. Rat Boy dominating most of this match. Rat Boy actually dominating most of the commercial break. Corkscrew, Latiato that time from Mitsuharu Misawa Throwdown Wrestling. Like, comment, subscribe. The reverse Ogo, the Plata, the Go-Go Plata inverted style that time, the reverse triangle choke, as we now see the modified stretch plum. Mitsuharu Misawa going from judo style wrestling to pure resu style wrestling. Does not skip a beat. Shot into the corner that time. Boot to the gut from Rat Boy. Rat Boy with the front face lock will cinch his opponent up top. And fans, we do this every Thursday night. Wait a minute. Avalanche. And wait a minute. And we actually see Misawa fire up. Yes, it was an avalanche suplex. The superplex for the American fans. Mitsuharu Misawa showing that fighting spirit fires up. Figure four jackknife. That's actually a move coined, invented, patented by Rat Boy. Rat Boy earlier on went for the Tiger Driver. Wait a minute. There it is. That sick variation. The Tiger Driver 91 shoots the half. Lateral press. Misawa Misawa, Misawa still, your number one contender, but what a great showing. From Yoshinari Ogawa, it is now time to make a massive announcement. One of the biggest announcements we've ever made. We're gonna make that for you right now. And it's gonna be about something that's gonna happen about a month from now. Fans, check this out. Great win from Misawa. You've asked for it, we will deliver. We will deliver Saturday, September 23rd. Still thinking about that awesome match we just saw. 8 p.m., our first live stream pay-per-view. It will be Destruction. Join the chat room. Main event time here. Tweet out the link. Tweet out this live stream, hashtag wrestling. Hashtag NJPW, hashtag Noah_GHC. Here comes Takeshi Morishima. Takeshi Morishima, a champion in Japan, champion all over the world. We're going to talk about that big championship he won back in 2005 in the United States when he defeated arguably the best wrestler in the United States today. We're going to get into that a little bit later on. But tonight, Takeshi Morishima in a must-win situation. He must win this if he wants to be considered a serious contender for the World Heavyweight Championship held by Kenta Kobashi. Unfortunately, he's got to go through this man. Let's bring out Shinjiro Otani. Have also demanded that Shinjiro Otani return to Throwdown, much like I said about the Destruction pay-per-view about 2 minutes ago. You asked, we deliver. Shinjiro Otani, a force to be reckoned with in this sport. A man who made his name in New Japan Pro Wrestling. A man who put Pro Wrestling 0-1 on the map. Much like Takeshi Morishima has competed and also been successful in the United States with World Championship Wrestling and also Ring of Honor Pro Wrestling. It is main event time. This, I believe, will be one of the greatest matches in Throwdown history. I couldn't be more pleased that I get to call this. You hear that opening bell. Arachnid Salt in the booth. Shinjiro Otani in the red and black. Takeshi Morishima in the black with the white trim on the boots. Greco-Roman knucklelock we just saw into the side headlock. Shinjiro Otani with the Shinbreaker. Throwdown Wrestling live stream. The summer of 2014, the action has never been hotter. Hit that like, hit that subscribe, leave a comment, and please tweet out the stream. Spinning leg lariat once again from Otani. Otani looking for the almost Funk Brothers style spinning toe hold. Could not get it, was kicked off. We see that drop kick and we see a receipt. And one thing you're gonna notice right off the bat, once again, is the weight difference between these two. When we talk about Otani, yes, Otani only weighing in at 225 pounds. At the same time, we talk about Takeshi Morishima weighing in at 290 pounds. Let's lay out for a second. Schoolboy! Let's lay out for a second. So you can hear some of the atmosphere here tonight in Japan in this main event. So you can hear, God, lariat from hell that time. So you can hear some of this stiff action. Folding press powerbomb. Could not get the job done. We've seen Takeshi Morishima win matches with that. It was actually on our very first ever live stream. The very first ever Throwdown match. when Takeshi Morishima was successful with that folding press powerbomb. There's the Amaze Impact, that reverse choke slam. From the high tension beast, the high intensity monster, Takeshi Morishima. I don't blame Otani here for taking a powder. Sends the big man back first into the guardrail. Otani will regroup, but let's talk about it. Let's talk about what was voted in the United States in the year 2005, the professional wrestling match of the year. In a lot of newsletters, on a lot of websites, by the smart fans, it was the Ring of Honor World Heavyweight Championship. The Ring of Honor World Championship, excuse me, that company not signifying if a belt's a cruiserweight belt or a heavyweight belt. No disrespect to the awesome promotion that is Ring of Honor. It was that night that Takeshi Morishima in the Manhattan Center in New York City, an event called Ring of Honor Manhattan Mayhem 2. That was the night Takeshi Morishima challenged the American Dragon, Bryan Danielson, for the Ring of Honor World Championship. And let's talk about the fact that Takeshi Morishima actually did win that Ring of Honor World Championship from Homicide in 2005. We can talk about the fact that, yes, it was Takeshi Morishima that almost ended the career of American Dragon Bryan Danielson, detaching his retina in one of those encounters between the two. When we talk about Shinjiro Otani, I think the first thing we've got to bring up is the WCW Cruiserweight Championship. Shinjiro Otani, actually the very first ever WCW Cruiserweight Champion. Now, people out there are going to say, well, you said that about Liger in the opening match. What I said about Liger was that he was the very first ever WCW World Light Heavyweight Champion. When Eric Bischoff took over that organization, he said, you know what, for the first time in professional wrestling on the main stage in the United States, we're going to show the cruiserweights respect. They're not just variants of the heavyweight division. They're cruiserweights. That belt, as we now actually see the King Cobra hold, the Shinano Naki, the Million Dollar Dream, the Cobra Clutch, call it what you will. Great wrestling here tonight. Shinjiro Otani actually battling in WCW with the likes of Dean Malenko and so many great. Shinjiro Otani, a great champion in the United States for World Championship Wrestling, as well as over here in Japan. Back to the main event. No one letting up here. We've seen hard hits, hard strikes. The action has been more fast-paced than you would expect from these two. Forearm shiver that time, cut, sits out. This Takeshi Morishima with the Fujiwara armbar. Takeshi Morishima, a damn near 300-pound man. And you would not believe it, but much like a Samoa Joe, he's not afraid to fly, as once again we see the Amaze Impact. Takeshi Morishima will come off the top rope, the middle rope, will dive to the outside. I've seen Scud missile drop kicks. I've seen Tope Suicidas, aka suicide dives, as we see that backbreaker from one Takeshi Morishima. And hell, if we're talking Ring of Honor, it was actually that same building. It was Joe's last match for Ring of Honor in New York City, where he took on Takeshi Morishima. Those two, both around 300 pounds, the conditioning, the cardio was OTM, was on the money. Those two tore the building down. Shinjiro Otani climbing up top. For a second there, looked to go Frankensteiner, was shoved off Takeshi Morishima with a stomp to the small of the back. Once again, fans, like, comment, subscribe. Otani floats through the scoop slam, grabs his man. There's the RNC, the rear naked choke, the sleeper hold. Cranked on it for good measure, will stay on him. Once again, back into the King Cobra clutch. Shinjiro Otani realizing that he's giving up a lot of weight here. He's gonna have to out-wrestle Takeshi Morishima as we see the Cobra Clutch. Excuse me, as we saw the Camel Clutch, we saw the Cobra Clutch a little bit earlier on, spinning leg Larry at that time. Shinjiro Otani in control here. I thought not, was gonna try to maybe powerbomb the big man, could not get him up. Shinjiro Otani looks to hit that spinning sit-out powerbomb, the spiral bomb. He also has a devastating Bridge and Dragon suplex, a full Nelson move, a move actually illegal in amateur wrestling. Look at this, Shinonaki clutch. It's a modified backbreaker. It's a modified King Cobra hold over the knee. Damn impressive that time from Takeshi Morishima, who dropped back. Look for the Jujigatami. Shinjiro Otani, the former amateur wrestling champion, the master of the springboard. Now with the German suplex, but he kept the clasp about 30 seconds ago to block what a lot of people call the cross arm breaker. Like I said earlier on, Otani once again will go back to the well. That time does score with the powerbomb. Shinjiro Otani going to the spinning toe hold once again. Could not get it. What an epic encounter we are witnessing here tonight. In the main event, both of these men have so much to gain from winning this match. Will this be a receipt here? No! Frankensteiner switches into the Jujigatami. What a beautiful counter that time on the powerbomb. When we talk about the records of these two men, let's talk about the fact Takeshi Morishima, a five-time Pro Wrestling Noah Tag Team Champion. And Morishima will come off the top this time. Like I said, he will fly. Scores with that trademark Scud Missile Dropkick. And Shinjiro Otani, I believe Shinjiro Otani has been busted open. I see the blood on the ring canvas. Yes, a bloody mess. And now sends Morishima headfirst into the ring post. This thing breaking down. Morishima now actually busted open. Head first once again into the ring post. Both of these men want this win. It is the very first time ever Shinjiro Otani in solo action has main evented a live stream here for Throwdown. He wants to make a great first impression on the fans as well as New Japan Pro Wrestling and Pro Wrestling Noah upper management. Shinjiro Otani, as we talked about Samoa Joe earlier, Shinjiro Otani, actually the innovator of that sick face wash, the boot rake in the corner move emulated by so many people, including Samoa Joe. Otani back into the corner that time. Mitsuharu Misawa, successful earlier on. Liger, successful earlier on. Both of these men look to be the last man who will be successful on tonight's live stream in this main event. Once again, the front face lock. Once again, Shinjiro Otani was going up top. The open hand palm strike was the answer. Spinning leg lariat sent the big man back into the corner. Shinjiro Otani, not to be deterred, snatches the side headlock. Side headlock actually trapped the arm that time. Very smart wrestling on the part of Otani. Otani maybe looking to go springboard. Thought better of it. Otani, one of the early masters of the springboard. I mean, hell, when Otani started doing that, you just didn't see that kind of thing in the United States. He was doing that in WCW. The springboard missile drop kicks. The springboard. Wait a minute here. Backdrop suplex. Great move that time from Shinjiro Otani, who once again maybe will look to go to that springboard. I don't know that Morishima's in position. Otani going sideways, trying his best, looking for that flying knee, could not connect. Takeshi Morishima unable to really capitalize the way there. I think he wanted to. The Yakuza-style boot in the corner that time. Front face lock here. Snaps off the damn near 300-pounder. And fans, I have to remind you guys, it is the Throwdown Library playlist. Every pay-per-view, the previous live stream, every event we've ever done. If you want to catch up, if you want to see where things started, if you want to follow the careers here in New Japan Pro Wrestling, in Pro Wrestling Noah, of these two guys, hell, if you just want to get educated about this sport, as we see the schoolboy, if you just want to get educated about this sport from a man who's studied it, from a man who's followed it, waist lock that time, Morishima breaks out. You have come to the right place. Back heel sweep. And once again, Shinjiro Otani looking for either the spinning toe hold or the figure four leg lock. There we saw the enziguri. Shinjiro Otani, whatever he's been looking for on that ankle has not been able to get it. Irish whip, the hammerlock throw. There's the rolling soul butt. the jumping sole, the rolling sole, the spinning back kick, depending on what sport you're used to seeing it in. High crotch, high collar, scoop and a slam, and the man in red and black. I believe this time we'll score with this springboard if he can get it off the top. Yes, scores with that springboard knee to the face, to the sternum of Takeshi Morishima. Morishima, so beasty, so tanky, not going down, went down to a knee. Low vertical base that time, answers the suplex attempt with a suplex, with a brain buster of his own. There's the atomic drop, going old school. Thought it might be that backdrop driver. I mean, hell, when we talk about the finishing moves of Takeshi Morishima, Morishima, his bread and butter, is the backdrop driver, that unprotected freestyle, sometimes Greco-Roman style, belly-to-back suplex onto the back or the top of a man's head. He's also been known to bring a stiff lariat. And you gotta wonder, Takeshi Morishima, a man who wants a shot. Wait a minute, let's call the action here. Powerbomb folding press. Takeshi Morishima, a man who wants a shot at Kenta Kobashi, the reigning IWGP World Heavyweight Champion. Kenta Kobashi likes to use the lariat. Do you think that Takeshi Morishima here tonight would like to send a message to the world champion by beating Shinjiro Otani with a lariat at the same time? It was a couple of weeks ago at an untelevised event, at a house show, that Shinjiro Otani damn near defeated, and yes, it was a Pro Wrestling 01 Max event. Otani damn near defeated Kobashi. Back to the well. This time scores. Snaps off that Scott Steiner style Frankenstein. Otani was looking for something there, could not get it, will stay on his man. There's the dragon suplex, release style. Otani feeling it, Otani fired up. Will he use that to set up for the sit out spiral bomb? Let's lay out here for a second. There it is. No, and Takeshi Morishima, the fighting spirit, getting right back up. The ring, a bloody mess. The heads of both of these competitors, a bloody mess. You are watching Throwdown Wrestling. Backdrop driver, that's the finisher of Takeshi Morishima. Will Morishima go for a cover? Like I said, this has been one of the greatest matches in Throwdown history. Irish whip that time. Lariato! North-south press, two. Takeshi Morishima gets the juke. Otani right back up. Right back up after the three count, face to face. Look at the mad dogging. Look at the stare down. Fans, keep it locked here for Throwdown Wrestling. In weeks and months to come, I do not believe this feud is over. Far from it. Takeshi Morishima in the main event makes a statement. Hard fought battle, bloody battle. And we have to thank you for joining our live stream. Join us Thursdays at youtube.com/arachnidsoul for Throwdown Wrestling. You've seen it, you've loved it, you've enjoyed it. You see what Arachnid Soul brings to the table. You see what Throwdown Wrestling brings to the table. Spread the word. We are enjoying the continued growth of this promotion. The summer has been exciting. Join us Thursday night for Throwdown, and join us next month for the Destruction pay-per-view, Arachnid Soul. Thank you, and good night.